Okay, then welcome. We just want to give you a quick overview about Amazon Web Services and what it offers for us all as educators. We are Christoph and Andreas, and we are actually as University of Applied Sciences in St. Pölten, a member institution of AWS Educate. And both of us, we are AWS Cloud Ambassadors, so we have a very good relationship with AWS so that we can really work together and do projects with AWS together.
Okay, so let's get started with AWS. First of all, what is AWS? AWS is one of the biggest cloud providers in the world. Here on this slide, you can see the market share of the cloud provider. And here you can see AWS has 31% of the market share worldwide. So it's one of the biggest or the biggest cloud provider in the world. So it is very important that educators and students know AWS, and yeah, they can use it, they know what to do with AWS and so on. So we go to the next slide. So which services are provided by AWS? First of all, we have some infrastructure services. You can see here some compute services like EC2, LightSail and so on. So they're all very infrastructure based. These are virtual machines, web hosting, serverless computing, and so on. This also includes different storage possibilities. And yeah, a lot of infrastructure service, network service, and so on. On the other hand, they have a lot of application services.
Yeah, so the cloud usually started with those basic services that you could just rent a computer and pay for it. But nowadays, as you see, most of the stuff of AWS is actually high-level services. So for example, there are a lot of machine learning services where you can just upload files like pictures and it does the classification for you, or you just rent really big machine learning optimized machines to do deep neural networks. You also have all the services like Poly and Lex for speech, speech recognition and speaking. And these services are actually used by Amazon Alexa, the biggest speech service worldwide.
So now we go to AWS Educate for Educators. So what is important for educators and why we want to use it? So Educate is Amazon's global initiative to accelerate cloud learning and prepare students and so on. So what does it mean? It is the education portal from AWS, which helps educators and students to learn about the services.
So normally when you sign up to AWS, you can of course sign up for free. You also get a lot of services for free. Like it says here, the AWS has 12 months for free tier access and then something going further. But there are some big disadvantages, especially if we as educators want to use it. First of all, we would have to have a credit card, a private credit card that we supply to Amazon, which then of course puts some kind of risk to us. You wouldn't get any kind of free credits, so no free money for us that you could just spend on something. And only some of the services are free, so with the starter account you can access everything with this free AWS account that AWS offers.
So, and yeah, because of that we want to use AWS Educate. Now to the registration process for it, it's very simple. There's a website where you can apply for AWS Educate. Same website for students and educators, then you get the verification email, you verify your email address, get the welcome mail, set the password, and then you're a member of AWS Educate, and you can, then you can use the whole web platform. So yeah, here we have a short introduction in the process of registration. First step here in the registration process is where you can decide between student and educator. And yeah, if you're an educator, please use educator. As a student, use student. Next one, this is an important step. Here you have to fill in a form, and for the school and institution name, you have to use the name of our institution, and we are registered as St. Pölten University of Applied Sciences. So this is important because when you use this institution, you get more credits. Also, please use your FH email address, and then you get the full benefits of the platform. Yeah, this is some kind. This is the welcome email. We skipped a few steps of verification emails and so on. And in the welcome email that you see here, a click here for setting your password. So this is the last step. You get to this web page, you can set the password, and then the registration process is done, and you can use the platform. Here you can see a screenshot of the platform. Yeah, different menu points, and to get the credits, the nicest part here, go to AWS account, and you can create your starter account. So,
yeah, so what is the starter account? So in contrast to the normal AWS account where you need a credit card, with the starter account that you can access through AWS Educate, you don't have to put your credit card. You get free credits, so it's $150 of credits that we as educators get. Our students get $100, which is still nice to get. You can access most of the services as well, so some very expensive services are not part of AWS Educate. And the really good part is that you have no risk at all. So this means that if you use all your credits, then your services are just deleted and they stop. So you don't have the risk that it charges everything above your free tier to your credit card and then suddenly you have a huge credit card bill. And that's really important because you can't do anything wrong in this starter account. The second option that you would actually have is, if you want to work with students, is that you create classrooms for them. So say the students also get some credits that they can spend as they wish, but on top of this, you can just say, I have a lecture from a starting date to an end date, and then you can get additional AWS credits so that you give every student, for example, $50 credit that they can only use for your class and the services that you want them to use for. So there are some templates available where you can just get this credits selection of what they can do and when your class starts and when it ends. So how does it work?
Okay. Now, if you go to your Educate portal, you can see here the classroom and credit tab, and here, yeah, you can see request or go to an AWS Educate classroom. Here you can create a new classroom with the additional credits and so on. You can see this is the creation form. Yeah, different course information you have to fill in, and here you get the amount of requested credits per student. So $50 is the default amount, and normally you don't need more than the 50 credits for a lot of different exercises in the cloud. So next one.
Yeah, next one is you can't just use AWS Educate for getting free stuff. You also have other free stuff as well. So in the left tab in the menu, you also have content, which are actually a lot of predefined courses where you can just download example slides that you can use in your classrooms. There are exercises that you can use, there are whole pathways and training instructions that you can use and adapt for your own class teaching. So what about AWS Educate for students? So this was our educator experience. We get the credits, we can create classrooms, we get some learning pathways that we can give them, but students have additional options, so we get them as well, but they are made for students. So they are, for example, cloud career pathways, which means that these are several courses that they can do, which last starting at around 5 hours up to 50 hours, where they have a specific topic where they can get an expert. It starts with rather simple topics like web development and goes over DevOps up to machine learning specialists, so that you can really do deep dives into all the cloud services and advanced features AWS can offer you.
Yeah, because you can also get some badges, some rewards for getting things done. Then we have some Alexa badges when you make some Alexa exercises, IoT, Amazon Sumerian, DeepRacer, and so on. So there's some kind of reward for students when they get some challenges done here. Another advantage is the job board. So students get a job board, for students, where they can find different jobs which are related to AWS. And yeah, it's a nice opportunity to get a job or to looking for a job. You see what is needed in the industry. And so on. So, last slide. Thank you.
We hope you're signing up. If you have any questions, please just contact us and we can also help you in your AWS journey.
And you get the sign up link in your in the email we will send you.